Welcome back. Thanks for joining me today. Sorry I didn't post a video last week. I've been a little bit preoccupied with this. Yes, after a long 8-year wait, I've finally bought another motorcycle and I'm back in the game. Once you kind of get that thing in your blood and the feeling of the wind in your hair or beard as the case may be, it's really hard to get rid of it. And so eventually I succumbed to the demon and bought another bike. Anyway, that's besides the point. I wanted to do a quick video today and just touch on the Oasis reunion. Everybody is talking about this at the moment. The hype is off the absolute chain. And I just wanted to give my thoughts on it. I'm a huge Oasis fan, to a degree. I'm not one of these people that lives and breathes every single word of every single song, but they have undeniable bangers, absolute bangers, and you know, like it or not, their sound defined a whole generation of people. They are a much loved band, and you know, them reforming, doing another tour was obviously going to be met with huge amounts of excitement. Now, what do I think about them getting back together now? Because it has been like, what, 15 years at this point since they broke up? Is it financially related? I think a lot of people would say it might be, but I don't think so. I mean, I know Noel is going through like some costly divorce or something at the moment, but you know, his High Flying Birds albums have done fairly well. Liam Gallagher's albums have done pretty well in the charts, so I don't think these guys are short of a penny or two. I honestly think, if I was to go with my gut feeling, I think that they're a pair of dickheads. They've argued for years and years and years. It bubbled to a point. As with all things, the passing of time is the greatest healer. And I think that eventually they've just been like, we miss it. Why wouldn't you? They had some of the best years of their careers in that band. You know, Nebworth and all that kind of thing. Absolutely mind-blowing crowd sizes. Why would you not want that again? Because obviously any Oasis tour is going to be met with absolutely massive ticket demand, which it already has. They've already added more dates as of this morning than what was originally announced. So the demand is huge. They're obviously going to make a packet off the back of it. And who doesn't want to do that as well? I mean, fair enough. So I don't necessarily think it's all financially motivated. I think it's just kind of the right time, or if they feel like it's the right time and enough time has passed for them to settle the shit and get on with it. So cool, I'm all for it. I've heard rumours that there may be a new album in the works. Give or take, for me, I don't really care. I'm going to try my best to get tickets for that gig purely to see them at their best, performing the best hits that I've always known and loved. I don't really care about new material. I think a long time has been and gone between when they were at their peak Oasis writing to now, and I think any new album would probably be fairly underwhelming. I'm not that bothered. I mean, don't get me wrong, I live to be surprised. They might just crop up with an absolute banger of an album, and in which case, I will buy it. I don't have a lot of high hopes on that. I did read a couple of articles slating the reunion of Oasis, one particular one from The Guardian, and a guy called Simon Price. Now, I don't know much about this guy, but to me, he just sounds like a bitter old man. I read the article and I was like, really, Simon? I mean, if that's what counts as journalism these days, fair enough. Generally speaking, the news has been met positively, I think, by a lot of people. And yeah, there's going to be some liberals who don't like what Liam has to say on Twitter, or, you know, I'm trying to choose my words carefully here so not get cancelled, but it's what it is. If you don't like it, don't buy a ticket. Don't listen to Oasis and shut up. You know, there's probably 50 million people out there that love Oasis, so let them buy the tickets and let them enjoy the evening. Jesus Christ. They must be searching for things to write about at the moment. Anyway, yeah, exciting news. And to be fair, I called this 5 years ago. I knew they'd get back together at some point. I think a lot of people knew this, right? It was inevitable. But the news has finally broken. Oasis are back. and I am going to try my level best to get a ticket. Back in the day, I never actually got a chance to see Oasis live. I suffered a back injury, unfortunately, and was hospitalised and bedridden for a while the last time they toured before they then subsequently split up, so it kind of left me wanting. So for me, this is particularly special news because I'll be able to finally see them live, and that's another one off the bucket list. So I'm all for it. No, let's go. There you go. Nothing but positive things to say, to be honest. I think it's great. I really do. Thanks for joining me again. And until then, take it easy. And for those of you that are going to the Oasis gig, see you down the front.